President, the first question that I want to raise to you is, where is the Council in this debate? We are giving here a message. It's not a message for Mr. Barnier, because Mr. Barnier is 100% behind us, I think, and we have the same opinion. And we have a message from who? For the Council. Why the Council is not here? No, no, it's not for the media, Mr. Callanan. You are doing that for the media because you are against maybe a banking union. That I can understand. So you are intervening. But that the presidency is not here, they have to make a new proposal to us. And Mr. Svoboda is totally right. It's totally unacceptable that it shall take now until... What is the date of the next ECOFIN, Mr. Barnier? 17th of something. The 17th of February, before they can have a new mandate. So that it's 14 days that we are losing again, in top of all the other months, because the Council decided on the banking union, Mr. Svoboda, in June 2012. In June 2012. And today they are not capable to define a new mandate so that the negotiations with the Parliament can really go forward. Because, let's be honest, we have already said a few times that the proposal of the Council was not acceptable and that we needed another one. And the dramatic point in this is that it is since 6 years that it's 6 years ago that the financial crisis started. 6 years ago. And we have still not a solution for the banking crisis. The Americans did immediately that. The first thing what the Americans did within a year after the start of the financial crisis was to recapitalize their banks and to solve the problem. What the Swedish did after their real estate and banking crisis, they did it. And what we are following is the path of the Japanese. They wait also 15 years before they could recapitalize their banks. And a long period of economic stagnation was the outcome of that approach. So I'm asking, Mr. President, that in the name of the Parliament, the United Parliament, you should really urge, send a letter to the Council President to say that it's not acceptable for us and that we are asking for to speed up their negotiations inside the Council so that they come with a new mandate. Then the second point is on the speed. I think everybody agrees. The speed we see now in the proposal of the Council, it's like a Trabant, if I can use the picture of a car. So a very long procedure, slow, where you need maybe a McLaren or a Ferrari if you want to solve a banking problem in a weekend. And so and finally about the legal base. As you know, I think there is only one good legal base, that's 114. Why? Because the money involved, the contributions, is private contributions. It's not the contributions of the banks. It's not public money that we want to be involved. So Article 114 is the right legal base. But I have already heard that some people are ready to make agreements on that, to compromise on that. Maybe we shall end with a sunset clause in this intergovernmental agreement at the end so that the whole system can fall later on in community law. That is what we normally do if we don't agree with the Council. We say, okay, you can start with that system, but within a year, within 2 years, within 5 years, the whole EGA has to fall into community law. That could be the outcome. Is that good? Maybe better than an EGA for eternity. But let's start this negotiation with the Council to stick to 114. If the legal service of the Council themselves, together with the legal service of the Commission, and together with the legal service of the European Parliament, if all three legal services are saying the same thing, it's a miracle, I should say. Because normally these legal services have always different opinions. This time they have the same opinion. And it's only because one country, it cannot be the biggest country, Chairman, is opposing it, that we are looking to a system, intergovernmental system, again, who is outside the treaties and who is in fact a negative point and has a negative outcome and a negative consequence for the powers of the European Parliament. Thank you.